Wow. I'm a stalker. Nita kustalk. I'll know where you live. I'll give the coordinates of where you live, where you are, your middle name, your maiden name, your mother's maiden name. Nitakupata. I'll know who your class teacher in class 2 was. Going to sit there and then you won't ask where the stop is from, like this is the level we're at in this relationship. You're not going to ask me where I bought this top. You're just going to sit there and look at me in this top and not ask me, oh gosh, why aren't you telling me where you bought this top? You're not going to ask. That's just how we're dealing. That's look at these two holes. Look at this top. Look. And you're not going to ask why you trash? Why you trash? You know, I might as well just leave you. I might as well just be done with you. Because this relationship is clearly not working. It's not working. It's just not. I got it from Yanega. You know, you're trash, but I accept you. Because, you know, in this channel, I accept you. There you go. That's the secret to my fabulousness today in this video. Yay! Clapping and happiness. Anyway, so I'm here to talk about a really. My lips are feeling dry. We can't have dry lips on this channel. Okay, so I'm going to do, Kai, why am I all up in your face? I haven't even started the story. Oh my God, I talk too much. My God. Listen. If you're stalking, sweetie, I don't have to know about it. Like, you can stalk, and the whole entire concept behind stalking is that the other person doesn't find out about it. Like, if you're stalking someone and they find out about it, hey, why is my tongue doing the damn thing, damn it? If you're stalking someone and they find out about it, you're doing a pretty sloppy job at the stalking. I think I should tell you that. Imagine when I was joining uni. The story just gets so dark. Have you ever stalked? I stalk all the time, man. Like, me. Wow. I'm a stalker. Nita kustalk. I'll know where you live. I'll give the coordinates of where you live, where you are, your middle name, your maiden name, your mother's maiden name. Nitakupata. I'll know who your class teacher in class 2 was. Nitakupata. Nitakutafuta. Na nitakupata. I will find you, sweetie. I will. It's just how life is. It's just how I've been conditioned to stalk and find, you know? Because, like, if I see you and I like what I see, you know, and something's going down, you know, I'm inclined. Like, it's beyond me. It's beyond me. Okay, that's the only logical explanation, surely. But, like, let me tell you guys, when I was joining uni, Mwadhans is a Kikuyu name. It's Mwadhani. Mwadhani is Kikuyu for ruler. And it's God. It's the name for God, but like I made it with a twist. With a little twist, you know, a little some. I'm black, so I'm black. I'm African, y'all. I add a lot of spice, you know. I am spice too, like just, you know, go. Kidogo nini? Kidogo. What are the spices out there? I don't know. Like, a lot of spice. Like, I just like to add a lot of spice. So, let me tell you guys. When I was joining uni, would not recommend, by the way. It's the ghetto. Oh my God, I'm in the ghetto. But listen, you have to hear me out. This story is so sad. Oh my God, this story just keeps getting worse and worse. And worse and worse and worse. Like, there's no happy ending. I think I've mentioned all this. moment of silence, because just tell me why you would be stalking and then I find out. Like, the whole essence of stalking is so you don't ever get caught. Like, you're doing a pretty sloppy job if you're getting caught up while you're stalking. So when I was joining uni, sweetie, you ain't ready for the story time. Nah. Sweetie, are you holding your cup of tea? Because, okay, ready? You think you're ready? Why? Where would you think that? Where did you get that idea? That's a very bad idea. Wrong impression of this story time. Can you imagine that this guy, I met a guy in my uni. And we were really close, like we were friends. So one time during, it was like we had lunch break, it was break time, let me call it break time. So one time during break, his other friend, you know, you understand, like a third person, wants to join the uni I was in at the time, and he wants to join the uni I was in. Wants to join my uni, yeah? So, I think I should give them names. So, I have a friend called Brian, and he has a friend called John. So, Brian and John are friends, yeah? And I was talking to Brian in the student center during break. And then his friend John comes and he's like, yo, what's up, bro? I really want to join your uni. Can you just like chill with me? You know, they chilled together because they're friends. And me, I was just like, ah, he's the friend of my friend. I could chill with him, you know? I could do a little some. Like, also, I didn't have a problem with it. I didn't think, like, anything of it, you know? It's just, the friend of my friend is probably just, like, my acquaintance. My friend? My acquaintance is better. So, like, Egwele Mani, let me tell you, yo. This guy, John, has no sense of, like, you know, personal feelings. Like, if I embarrass you in front of your friends, you're going to feel like embarrassment, like blush face, like weird smile, awkward, I don't know, awkward face. You'll have an awkward face, yeah, when you're embarrassed or something, or when you feel like something is wrong. When you're angry, you'll have an angry face. When you're happy, you'll be happy, yeah. So this John guy has like none of that. His face is like a constant, like, so have you given him a constant face? There you go. That's the constant face that I'm talking about. Like, no feelings, no emotions on the face, yeah? It's like he's just alive. He's just alive, and he has like a permanent grin. Like a permanent smile. He has like a permanent smile. And this John guy, he's a little crazy. He's a little crazy, I must admit. He's like insane. On the first day we met, I told him, oh, I'm so hungry, take me to buy food. So we went and bought bacon fries, and then we went to the rooftop where his friend Brian was at the time. So after chilling all of my break time with him, I went to the rooftop with John to meet Brian, so I can take him back to Brian. Brian had a class, so that's why I was chilling with John. But when I took John back to Brian, It was nothing. I didn't think anything of it. I was just taking him back to his friends so they can chill, because he doesn't know the school that well, yeah? Nisha choka, bro. So when I was leaving the rooftop, because I was running to go for my class, John shouted, like, my name. You know, this is why I actually tell you guys my first name, but my dad thinks it's the name of an old person, which it is, because it's my grandmother's name, because, like, I'm just trying to cushion you because you're not ready for my first name. And I don't think I should say it. It's hard, man. It's hard out here. Anyway, so when I was running to the rooftop, like to the stairs so I can go to class, he shouts like from far. He's like, and I told him my actual name. My God, why am I like this? He's like, Gladys, you didn't give me your number. I'm sorry, what? Why would you shout my name like that? It's not common knowledge. Not everyone knows my name. Don't be out here just screaming my name. Mini Wenu. Where? But I didn't have a problem with it. So I went back and then I gave him my number, because only because he made it so awkward. If I refused, it would have been so embarrassing for him. Whoa. I can imagine all his street cred gone. Nyambu ameenda nayo. Ndio huyo. Umemwona hapo? Hapo nini hapo Thika Road? Umemwona kikimbia nayo? She's gone. She's gone with all his street cred. Let me tell you, you're not ready. I keep telling you guys you're not ready, because you're actually not ready. So after he after like some time, I gave him my number. Actually, I did give him my number, and he started texting me, but I'm really not a good texter. I know I'm trash because I say that, and if I'm not a good texter, I'm just not a good texter. To see me accept, those people on Twitter who always like, if they say they're not a good texter, that's a red flag. It might be a red flag. I might not want to be talking to you, or I might just not be talking at all. Have you guys considered that? Anyway, I don't like the shine that lip balm gives you. Anyway, so I left him. Like, I went to class and he started texting me and all that, all more shenanigans. But I wasn't really replying. I was just absent. I was an absent texter. So when he actually joined the uni, which was like a couple of weeks after, my life changed forever. Feel totally, completely, 1000% changed. Do you know this guy started, now at first I didn't have a problem with him, because one time I used to live in some hostel with my friends and I loved it. It was so much fun. So that was disgusting, but my eye is itching and there's nothing you can do about it. Yeah, so when he joined school, I started to talk to him, like, now in person. So he started talking to me. I didn't think anything of it, you know. It's just like another person. People meet people in uni all the time. And that was just another person, I guessed at the time. So let me tell you, so one time when I was walking home with my friend Erica, we met the guy and he's like, oh, this is your way home? And I was like, yeah, it is my way home. And then he said, oh, so maybe we could be going home together. And I didn't think that was a bad idea, to be honest. It was a really nice idea. Like, it's okay, it's cool, I have no problem with you, so I just go with him. So when we started walking, we started going home together. Like, sometimes he'd call me after class and then he's like, are you in school? Can we go home together? So me, Erica and the guy used to go home together. Then at some point he stopped, like, he texted me and told me, can we go home together, just you and me today? And I was like, ah, you know what, me, I have no problem with it. Like, it's okay, let's just go home together. But sometimes, even when we were with Erica, sometimes when we were with Erica, we'd go home and then when it's time to leave, he'd hug Erica and then he'd hug me. But then when I'm trying to break it off, he'd hold me like longer, and I'm just like, oh, okay, dada, you know, like the okay, bye, you know, kind of hug. So that was a red flag that I missed, of course, you know. God was like, sweetie, here's a red flag for you. And I was just like, ain't nobody got time for that. So that's the first instance. Like, gradually I started to feel like he's coming on a little bit too strong. Like, I, you know, there's a crushing on someone where you come at them and you're like, hi, you're so smart today, where are you going, how's school, blah blah blah. They throw in their punchlines. They throw in the, what's that word? Pickup lines. They throw in the pickup lines, and you know, if you hear something ticking, it's just a time bomb. It's here, I'm just chilling, you know, with it, because I'm gangster like that. So he started coming a little bit too strong, like there's something about you that I don't quite like. I don't know what it is yet, but I actually don't like you that much. You're not very likable by me. You're not very liked by Nyams. And I like everyone. My mama don't like you and she like. Hey. So he started coming a little bit too strong. A little bit too strong for me. He started saying, hey, today these cuckoos have behaved. Hadi, I'm even shocked to hear Henry saying hi to y'all. Have you guys said hi back? So Henry, Mwadan. Nilimuita nani uyu? John. I'm a brayo. John. So John starts to be weird, and soon I understand him. Like, he's coming on a little bit too fast. He told me he liked me and I told him I don't like him. Like, I tried to look for an excuse and I told him I like someone else. Well, that didn't work at all. Actually, does that person like you? He had a point from. Hey, damn, this nigga spin. Anyway, hi Duru, doesn't matter. Did I die? I'm here. Oh God, no, my butt. So he started, soon I realized like he might be a psychopath, because sometimes I'd be sitting in a bench with my friends over a table, you know? So we're like six friends of mine, like we're just six girls sitting together just discussing life and being happy in uni. And suddenly this guy will just show up and be like, Nyambura, can I talk to you? And I'm like, no, I'm busy. I'll talk to you later. Like, I'm just trying to brush him off. This guy wasn't being phased. Like, that wasn't... It's like, look for another reason. That's not a reason. He actually insists. Like, please, Nyambura. You know, this is where that thing for, like, no feelings, no emotions thing comes on. This story gets a little bit too dark even for me. He starts to like beg, Nyambura, please Nyambura, please, for 5 minutes, just 5 minutes. And I'm like, okay, sawa. So I'd go and talk to him. I'd give in, because I mean, he beg, it's awkward now. Like, my friends were just quiet looking at him wondering, hiya. That happens. People do that. I had no idea. I had zero idea. People actually do that. People are mad. People be moving mad. People crazy. People are insane. Yo. I remember one time I was going home through some routes, like the back route, and it's like a path. And legit dead ass. He pulled my hand. And in this uni, by the way, they have like restrictions. You can't just be out here touching people. Imagine he pulled me to a bench and he, please talk to me. I'm just like, Jesus, this is not even a game. I actually don't want to talk to you. What's happening? Nini? Why don't you understand? My God, I don't want to talk to you, and it's not even a joke. That's on period. I'm going to tell on you to the administration. This is coming off a little bit too much. Like, you're coming off too strong on me. Relax, Kebu, sit down. Sit back down. Relax. Can you? Corona distance, please. This person used to send me photos of me that I don't even have. Why would you send them to me? Keep them? But first of all, the guy, Warutaku, umetoa wapi? Where did you get them from? Like, oh, you're so creepy. Oh my God. One night I was in the library and I was going home. It was a solid 9:30, like a very solid 9:30 p.m. And I was rushing because I had curfew in my hostel, which makes no sense, but okay. So I'm hurrying. And I was with my friend. So we're walking through the parking lot so we can get to the gate and just leave the uni and go to a place. And my and this guy shows up at night. Guy. Wallahi, if you've been watching Akina Forensic Files, Akina Criminal Minds, CSI, a lot of like, what's this thing called? If you've watched this thing, if you have the slightest knowledge of anything to do with like forensics and all that, you're mad scared. Like, this could be scary. This guy could kill you. I blocked him eventually. I was like, I blocked him. Kitambo, Ali, like, as soon as he kept texting me and I wasn't replying, I blocked him totally. And now it was getting crazy because I was like, please don't talk to me. And he kept showing up to places. I'm like, what's happening? So eventually one night in my hostel, it was a Sunday night, I was going to buy airtime because I wanted to call my mom. I was going to buy airtime and outside my hostel there was like a roundabout, and then on the sides there are cars parked, and then there was a supermarket, and then there was like a shop, an actual shop where I was going to buy the airtime. But I used the long route there because I was texting, I was using my phone, I was doing a lot of things. So while I was walking, I'm on my phone, remember? So I'm walking, but like I'm diverting from the road because I'm not looking at the road. So I was walking towards like a dead end, a place where there was like a hedge and a car parked, and this is a hedge. So I'm walking here. You understand? You get it? You're smart. So I was walking towards that place, but I didn't know, of course, because I'm just using my phone at night. And suddenly I felt a heavy hand on my shoulder. Like it was such a grab, like a kujapa kind of thing. I was like, hey, you know, I was scared, like, God, I'm gonna get mugged. I deserve it though, because I'm walking alone at night to go buy airtime on a deserted place because it was a Sunday night, people are home. And that was on me, like, I was at the wrong place at the wrong time. No one needs to feel like that, but like that's where I was. No one needs to feel unsafe like that, but I was doing it anyway. So I felt a heavy hand on my shoulder, so I turned, like, I was startled. I'm like, what the hell, who is this? So I turned, and guess who I see? Excuse me, guy, your dasiti yote mnabebanga wapi na vile wewe ni mfupi, where are you hiding all this audacity? Where are you carrying it? Iko todo, I'm not seeing it. Like, where? There's not enough storage space in you for all this audacity that you have. Okay, that's just too much audacity. Can you believe when this person said ati, I turned around and I was startled, like, where are you from? I asked him, were you drunk? I asked him if he was drunk, because he looked drunk. So I asked him, are you drunk? Because he was panting also. I'm like, okay, maybe you ran to come see me or something. I don't know. I don't want this thing. Stalking. Dinkwenda, imagine I don't want. Gosh. He came and I asked him, where are you from? Like, where are you from? Are you drunk? Because Kilosh was right there. And he told me, ati, no, he wasn't drunk. And he told me that he's coming from his hostel. And I was like, oh, okay, it's around, you moved. At first I was like, you moved? Because he used to live at home with his folks. And now I'm like, okay, you moved? And he said, yeah, I moved. I asked him if he lives nearby now. You know, you won't believe what I'm about to tell you. Utaamini kweli? Utawezana? Ukongo? Utawezana? Utawezana? Will you be able? Do you have enough storage space for this piece of information? Henry's like, shut up, turn it off! Okay. Imagine he had moved into my hostel, but like, I don't have like, I'm so tired. He moved into my hostel. This ticking time bomb almost went off when I said he moved into my hostel. That's how scared we are. Even the bomb is scared. That makes no sense. But you're going to listen anyway. Because I'm controlling everything you're hearing in this channel. Ooh, dominance. Love it. Listen. He had moved into my hostel. At this point, I really don't have like a way out. I can't run away. Like now I'm like caught up. Caught up in a trance. Caught up in a trance. My friend has a song called Caught Up in a Trance. Ooh, hi Mugami. Hi DKY Simba. Hi Dad. Imagine he had moved into my hostel. And then he told me to give me your hands. I'm like, what? Are you guys listening to this? Ati, give me your hand. No. No, I will not do that. I'm not giving you my hand. And then he actually took my hand. Then he told me to give him my other hand. And I was like, I don't think I want to give you my other hand. You've already taken my first hand. He took my other hand. Forcefully, like really hard. And I kept telling him, you're hurting me. And then he said, Ati, no, I'm not. Are you me? Is you us? Are we is me? Is... You bear a striking resemblance to people who laugh and hit you. Me, I'll kill you. Why are you hitting me? Nothing is funny enough for you to hit me. It's never that funny. It's never that funny. So, this guy actually starts to... It's too graphic. I can't even see it here. But let me just say, it ended with me breaking off and running away and telling him to leave me alone. And he comes, like, he walks behind me. As I walk now, I'm running towards, like, my hostel. I'm walking back home. I ran, and he starts to walk behind me. Like, he starts to walk. And this guy doesn't have ordinary steps. I've made him sound like such a bad person, but I swear to God. You know people who walk like they're stamping on their feet? Like, their feet are stamping on the ground. That's exactly how he sounded, like, when he was coming. I don't know if it was my head. Did I give him effects? Or was I just trying to, like... So terrified. Long story short, I moved out of that hostel. I live at home now with my folks. But he used to. I blocked him. He used to send me black snaps, like a snap on Snapchat with like a black background. And then you know how you can edit, like you can type in something on a snap. So he typed in and he'd write like, "We will be together, Gladys." Stay away from me, Satan. I speak the blood of Jesus. Just stay away from me. Please, just stay away from me. Just don't come. Guy, he was so scary. Oh my gosh. He was so scary. that's my story time with stalkers. That's my, I mean, stalkers are generally, generally stalkers are very good people. But I don't like to risk because I don't know who you are. I don't know what you are. I don't know what you will do to me. I don't know. Can you stalk like on the low? Can you just like go on, I don't know what app, and just like go on Facebook, stalk me, find out who my mother is, where we live, how we do it, how we cook githeri, how we, on Sundays we eat chapo, on Wednesdays we eat chicken. You need to go and stalk and be low-key about it. Jesus. The streets ain't what they used to be. People stalk like that normally. Like, this got to like physical stalking. And there was a show on Netflix about stalking. I watched the whole thing because I'm dark like that. But like, on the first episode, there was a Chinese man who lived in the US with alone. He'd been working there for 22 years. He'd never gone back home. He'd been working there as like a manual laborer. I don't know what he was doing. But he started talking to some lady. I don't remember what her name was, but it starts with a K or a C. It's a K sound. So he used to get drunk, then come and call her name all the time, like screaming her name, like out of her apartment, like screaming her name, Carol, while he's drunk. And then eventually he convinced her to get into his house, and he stabbed her because she wanted to leave, and until she said she was going to stay. And that's just not the kind of stalking I am into. Please, there's a difference. Okay, online stalking is great, it's perfect. Physical stalking though, it's a no-no. Do not do physical stalking. Do not stalk people physically. You hurt them emotionally and mentally. You get into their heads and they start being very paranoid. They start getting very paranoid and they could do anything, to be honest. It could lead to any accidents. It is that serious. So if you're stalking someone physically, please stop. Please, like, nicely. I'm asking nicely. You see, I'm smiling. Please stop stalking, like, physically. It's not appealing. It's not right. It's not okay. I don't stand with stalking. Like, stalking could lead to impotence. I will kick you in the nuts. I'm not joking. I post a joke. Well, I could get physical. And so could the person who's stalking you. Well, this story has been long. 28 minutes. Crap. And I still have to do so many edits. And I'm just so tired. And the video has to go up today because I went to the salon yesterday. Can you see how cute I'm looking? I'm looking cute. Oh, it's not the hair, it's the top from Yanni Girl. I'm gonna leave the link to the page on the description box.